Hi, it's Amber from Sweet Am's Cookies. In this tutorial, I'll show you how I made these Halloween gown cookies using a candy corn cookie cutter, a filigree stencil, and royal icing transfers. Start out by tracing the dress template with an edible ink marker onto a candy corn-shaped cookie. See the description for a link to the templates I'm using for this project. Ice the bodice of the dress with white, flood consistency royal icing. This icing is 15 to 20 second count. See the description for a link to my class, Royal Icing 101, to learn all about icing consistencies. Use a scribe tool to help shape the icing. Ice the skirt with black flood consistency icing. See the description for a link to my guide on making black icing and how to prevent color bleed. While the icing dries, place the skull template under a piece of parchment or wax paper. Ice the skulls with red 30-second count royal icing and a decorating tip 1, avoiding the eyes and the nose. Use a scribe tool to help shape the icing. Allow the icing to dry for about 20 minutes. Fill in the eyes and the nose with black flood consistency royal icing. This is the same icing that was used to flood the dress. Allow the cookies and the royal icing transfers to dry overnight. If you have a stencil holder, you can use it for this part, but if not, you can just hold the stencil by hand. I'm tracing the stripes with an edible ink marker. You can also airbrush the stripes if you like. I'm not that comfortable with my airbrush yet, so I prefer to do it by hand. Place the filigree stencil over the cookie. You might have to move it around a little bit to find the way that it fits best. Spread a thin layer of red, medium consistency royal icing over the stencil. Remove the stencil and clean up the edges with the scribe tool. Pipe beaded trim on the dress with red medium consistency icing and a tip 1. This is the same icing that was used on the stencil. Remove the royal icing transfers from the parchment paper. Use a little bit of royal icing to attach the transfers to the dress cookie, and then you can use the scribe tool to help push them into place. And these are the finished cookies. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any questions or if you have a suggestion for a design that you'd like to see in a future video, just let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time. Bye!